Hi, this is Reverend Jesse W. Plater, the senior pastor of Alexander Memorial Baptist Church, located here in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. I would like to take a moment to welcome our first-time visitors and those who are returning to worship with us today. The Bible says, "This is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it." We have prepared some clips from our choir and our worship services for your enjoyment. Afterwards, I will return with a word from God entitled, "It's Been Long Enough." We pray that you will be blessed and encouraged by our service today. Those of you who are viewing via Facebook, this would be a great time to hit the share button and to share the service with your family and friends. God bless you. Let's get ready to worship.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Alleluia. You have won it all for me. Death could not hold. You are the risen King.
100 songs, and it tells us to make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God.
It is he that hath made us,
and not we ourselves.
We are his people.
And the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. And into his courts with praise.
Be thankful unto him.
and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his truth endureth to all generations. That means you, you, and you, and you, and you.
Father, it's in the name of Jesus that we come, giving you thanks, honor, and praise, Lord, for being God and being God all by yourself. Lord, we thank you now for watching over us as we slept last night, that no hurt, harm, or danger came upon us, Father. Lord, we thank you for this moment, Lord, that we are about to receive the word of God, Lord, from the man of God. We thank you right now for bringing it forth, Lord, with power and conviction. We thank you for the many avenues that we have to receive your word on today. Lord, we just ask now that you would heal this land, Lord God. Lord, we know that you're able, and we know that there is a purpose for this. And Lord, we thank you in advance for healing everyone under the sound of my voice. In Jesus' name we pray and give thanks. Amen.
Good morning, and thank you for joining us for worship at the Alexander Memorial Baptist Church. Here are your announcements and events for this week. The Journey of Hope Cancer Support Ministry conference call will be held on Monday night at 7 p.m. Our adult Bible study will be held on Tuesday at 7 p.m. via Zoom. Our Youth Hot Topic Small Group virtual meeting will be held on Thursday at 7 p.m. on Zoom. And on Friday, our Young Adult Friday Night Live Bible study will be held at 7 p.m. on Zoom. Conference call and Zoom link information can be found online on our website at www.alexandermemorial.org. As a reminder, tithes and offerings can be submitted using the church website at alexandermemorial.org or on the Givelify mobile app. Download the Givelify mobile app and look for the Alexander Memorial Baptist Church of Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Also, tithes and offerings can be mailed to the church at 10675 Crane Highway in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Thank you for joining us for worship this morning right here at Alexander Memorial Baptist Church, where Reverend Jesse W. Plater is our senior pastor.
Speak it.
Give God some more praise and some more glory in the house today. We thank God for our choir and that wonderful selection that they have blessed us with. Come on, just lift up your hands. Go ahead and give God a praise offering right there in your house. Let God know just how much you appreciate him, how much you love him today. Go ahead and shout hallelujah as we get ready to go to the word of God. God bless you and may heaven smile upon you today. Today, we will be sharing with you out of the book of Deuteronomy in the Old Testament. Deuteronomy, the first chapter, verses 6 through 8. And I'll be reading from the New King James Version. And it says, "The Lord our God spoke to us in Horeb, saying, 'You have dwelled long enough at this mountain. Turn and take your journey and go to the mountains of the Amorites and to all of the neighboring places in the plain, in the mountains, in the lowland, and in the south, and on the sea coast, and to the land of the Canaanites and to Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates. See, I have set the land before you. Go in and possess the land which the Lord swore to your fathers, to Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, to give to them and their descendants after them.'" Amen. Amen. I like to use for my title today, "It's Been Long Enough." It's been long enough. Let's seek God in prayer. Father, we thank you, God, for your word today. We thank you, Father. We ask that you would just breathe on us, God, touch our hearts, our minds, our soul, and our spirit. Give us ears to hear and hearts to receive what thus says the Lord. Have your way, God. In me, your vessel, have your way, God, over your people, Father, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. It's been long enough, amen. And we see here in this book of Deuteronomy, the first chapter, we find where Moses speak. God is speaking to Moses and the children of Israel. They are in the wilderness, and it's been 40 years, if you would look at verse number 3, that the children of Israel have found themselves in the same place, amen. They are able to look across the Jordan River and see the promised land, amen, but they have not been able to get there yet. And so as we examine our text, amen, the first word I would like to share with you is the word ready, amen, ready. Again, it's been 40 years of wandering in the wilderness, again, according to verse 3. And everything that God has promised their ancestors and to them, amen, that he brought the children of Israel out of Egypt, and they were just on the other side of the river was their promise, amen. The people had become complacent and complainers and unfaithful to the word of God. And sometimes you can be just that close to your promise. It could be right around the corner, but our unfaithfulness sometimes can cause us to miss out on that very thing that God has prepared for us. And so here Moses reminded the people that God promised them that the land was good, amen? And how many know when God gives you a promise, you can stand on it? You really don't need anything else, but the children of Israel, that God's word wasn't enough for them. And so they requested to send 12 spies to check out the land for themselves. They wanted to see for themselves if the land was as good as God said it was. Oh, they wanted to see for themselves the enemies that was occupying the land, whether or not our God was able to defeat them or not. But how many know that was a sign of unfaithfulness? Because if God said it, then we know that you can count on it. And so they sent out their 12 spies. And they come back with a report, and we know the story that they 10 gave a bad report. 10 said the land is good, but there's some giants over there. But God had two that went with them named Joshua and Caleb. And Joshua and Caleb say, yeah, there are some giants, but our God is able. How many know that God is able today? God is able to do anything. And so, but the people chose to follow the report of the other 10 spies and refused to go into the land. See, God has declared, how many know when God declares something over your life, you have to learn how to trust God in spite of what things may look like. You have to learn how to trust God in spite of what somebody else might say. How many know this morning that God has declared over your life that you are blessed? And so I'm not going to let what somebody else said determine whether or not I believe God. If God declares that I'm blessed, then I'm blessed. God said, you shall live in the overflow. Anybody ready to walk in the overflow? He said, you shall live and not die. You shall be the head and not the tail. God declared that you are victorious, that you are more than a conqueror. God declared that you are healed. Tell somebody, in spite of the doctor report, I'm going to believe God. I don't know about you, but whatever God says, I'm going to believe. There used to be a song out that says, who report will you believe? Somebody said this morning, I'm going to believe the report of God. God says that you've been on this mountain long enough, is what he's telling the children of Israel. It's time for you to turn and take your journey. How many know that sometimes you can hang around somewhere too long? And God
tells them now it's time for you to move. He said, you've been around this mountain too long. And anybody know that sometimes mountain can be places and mountain can be situations and mountain can be circumstances that you're presently in. But anybody know that's not where you belong. God is saying this is not where you belong. Whatever you're going through, this is not where you belong. This is not the place of your promise. Somebody say, it's not my promise. Go ahead and tweak it. It's not my promise. Somebody might say, well, I'm living in poverty, but I come by to tell you, you don't belong there. I've been on this low-paying job and poor benefits and no opportunity for promotion. How many know I'm tired of this? I've been here long enough. I can't go out of the house, hey, ma'am, after a certain time of night. I can't go walking or jogging in certain neighborhoods. I can't even sleep in my own bed without the fear of someone bursting down my door and shooting me 8 times. It's time for me to leave this mountain. I'm tired of the mountain of empty promises. I'm tired of the mountain of overcrowded schools. And I'm tired of the mountain of young black men spending their adulthood in jail instead of college. It's time for me to leave this mountain. A mountain of poor housing and mountain of bad schools and mountains of terrible grocery stores and mountains with liquor stores on every corner. I said mountains with gunshots all day and all night. Mountains with drug-infested streets. Tell somebody, mountain with high employment. I've been here long enough. It's time for me to leave this mountain. I'm tired of the mountain of young black men and young black women dying from police brutality every day. Tell somebody, I need to get out of this wilderness. I feel like I'm traveling in circles and I'm moving, but I'm not going anywhere. Anybody ever been there? I'm not making any progress. I made up my mind that I'm going to trust God. Anyone made up your mind you're going to trust God in spite of what everybody else says, in spite of what all the other reports says? I just believe that God has something better for me. Tell somebody, you better get ready. Get ready, because it's time for you to leave this mountain. God tells the people, you have dwelled here long enough. Tell somebody, I've been through this thing long enough. I don't put up with this long enough. I've been denied long enough. It's time for me to leave this wilderness, because there's nothing here for me. I'm trusting God. I'm believing that He has something better for me. Anybody know God has something better for you? I'm moving out. I'm going to trust you. I'm coming out of my wilderness. I'm going to move away from this mountain because God has some better mountains for me. Somebody ought to give God praise. Go ahead and text and tweet. It's time to get ready. But then as I continue to examine this text and listen to what the Spirit of God is saying, as we look across our world and see what's happening, I find the word reform. Somebody say reform. Reform means to improve or amendment of what is wrong. Reform means I'm unsatisfied with the way things are now. God tell Moses and the people they are to turn and take their journey. Say yes, somebody. The Lord tells them this. It's time for you to move, he tells them in verse number 7. They going to the mountains, he said, of the Amorites. And he says, to all of the neighboring places in the land, in the plain, in the lowland, in the south, and to the land of the Canaanites. Other words, God says that what I have for you, somebody else is occupying it, but it's time for you to go and put possess the thing that I have promised you. When you look at this thing, he said it's time for you to turn. And when I look up the word turn, it says the word turn is an act of changing or reversing your position or your posture. Another meaning for this word turn is to rotate. Tell somebody, God is getting ready. It's time for you to rotate. It's time for you to change your position in your posture. Tell someone, get ready, because reform is coming. And to move to your new mountain. He said, all of the neighboring places. Tell somebody, God has so much more for you. Years ago, they were talking about that in the housing market. They said that the housing market was going to get to this place where the bubble would burst. And eventually it burst. And so the value of people's homes became lower than the loan that they had taken out. And what I discovered, we at this other place where there is another thing that's getting ready to burst, or that has burst rather, is called racism. And how many know, just like the housing market affected so many people, this thing called racism is affecting people not only here in America, but all over the world. Say yes, somebody. People are being forced to have what is said, this uncomfortable conversation with people of other races. How many know it's time for us to sit down at the table and have those conversations that needs to be had? If you look at what's happening in our country as a result of George Floyd's death, and so many others, one can see a reversing, a changing, a rotation in how people are viewing and valuing the lives of Black Americans. Somebody ought to say, yeah, we're seeing a reversing position from large organizations like the NFL concerning players kneeling during the national anthem. Some of America's biggest companies are now responding to public pressure to donate to anti-racism and campaigns and to publicly stand by Black communities following the death of George Floyd. Hear me, somebody. We see states and cities are starting to revise their law enforcement policies as attempt to reform their police departments. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, General Mark Milley, on Thursday expressed regret for his actions and his presence during a photo op down at Lafayette Square. Come on, somebody. I looked up the definition of the word rotate. Help me now. It says to cause to go through cycles of changes. How many can feel some changes, some cycles beginning to change? America is going through a rotation in its relationship between Black and white. White America. Help me, somebody. It's supposed to be one America, but everybody know that we're living in two different worlds. But the truth of the matter is our world has collided with one another over the killing of numerous Black males and females in our cities all across the country. The killing of George Floyd in Minneapolis served as a catalyst for nationwide protests against police brutality and racism against Black people. People like Trayvon Martin and Tamir Rice and Michael Brown and Eric Gardner and Philando Castile and Breonna Taylor and so many more others. These are just regular men and women. These are just regular people. They have mothers and they have fathers and some of them even have children. They just regular people like you and I. They had dreams and hopes just like you and I have. I say there's a change. Things are starting to shift. I feel a cycle is beginning to take place. People are putting themselves at risk protesting all over the world and here in America against racial injustice. Even during this pandemic season, people are coming together to say enough is enough. The funeral service for George Floyd was carried on all of the major networks. Just a regular guy being used by God to create something major all over the world. How many know God can use anybody? I tell you, God is doing something. People are saying to our leadership all over our countries and our states and our cities and our town, it's time to leave the wilderness of racism and bigotry and hatred and unfair laws and corruption and so many other things. It's time to leave those things behind us. It's time for reform across our country. But then thirdly, as I rush on and I look at this, the next word that I'd like to share with you is the word relinquish. That means to give up. How many know in verse 7, God says here, when we look at it, in verse 7, he says, turn and take your journey and see I have set the land before you. Though it would be a challenge, God has set the promised land before Israel. There came a time when you just can't stay where you are any longer. I can't stay in this career. How many know whether it's my career or my finances, my relationships, even race relationships, how many know there come a time when we say, I just can't stay here any longer. I can't deal with this any longer. I can't put up with this any longer. Change have to come. It says that you're going to have to relinquish. God told Israel that they had dwelled long enough at the foot of Mount Horeb. It was now time to turn and take their journey, come on somebody, to an unfamiliar place, this place called promise. How many know God has a promise for you too? And he's calling us out. He's calling each of us. He's saying it's time for you to move from your place of complacency, your comfort zone, and it's time to move out to that unfamiliar territory. God said, I has already given it to you. The children of Israel, they did not obey God. They did not believe his word. And so they rebelled and they refused, as I said earlier, to go into the promised land. And so their relationship caused them, and their disobedience and their unfaithfulness caused them to miss out on the blessing of the promised land. And so God let them wander in the wilderness for 40 years until that unfaithful generation had died out, except for Joshua and Caleb. But how many know God was working on a new generation? After the older generation had died out, God said, now it's time for you to go and possess the land. He had a new generation that was faithful and trust him at his word. If you look around, you can see that God is using a new generation to go in and possess the land which he swore to our forefathers, to possess those things that he had promised our forefather. There's a new generation. He's using that next generation to move us to new mountains and places that we never occupied before. There's a people that's already possessing the land. He says that the Amorites are there and the Canaanites are there. The Canaanites are there, but God is redeeming it from them and going to give it to us. Tell somebody, they're going to have to relinquish what they have. In order for our country to truly change the way it must repent of its sins. Some of those who have is going to have to give to the have-nots. Say yes, somebody. Those who have benefited from being privileged in our society and in our country going to have to learn how to share some of their privileges so that others can be privileged also. Y'all ought to hear me in here. Other words, it's not enough for one thing for you to donate. It's not enough to donate, come on, some of your privileges privilege money for our cause or as a gesture of your support, but how many know you're going to have to open up the executive boardrooms and you're going to have to open up so that people like me and you, black people, can sit at the table of decision just like everyone else. It's not enough just to give us a few dollars. We're not going to be satisfied with that. You're going to have to open up the door. It's not enough to give us a job working in the mailroom, but you're going to have to open up the opportunities so that we can become supervisors and we can become SESs and we can become CIOs and we can become secretaries of a department, that we can become other leaders. It's not enough to just put us in and give us a little something. We want the same thing that everybody else have. So you're going to have to relinquish some of the stuff that you have. You're going to have to open up the doors that's been closed. Somebody ought to hear me. Now, it's not enough for you to say that we were wrong about the flag. Come on, somebody. When you blackball Colin Kaepernick from the NFL for protesting against police brutality by kneeling during the national anthem, you're going to have to give him his job back. Somebody say it's not enough. You're not going to be able to discriminate anymore in your housing, in your hiring practices, in your lending practices, and in the criminal system anymore. Things going to have to change. Somebody ought to say yes. You're no longer going to be able to say you're not a racist, but you support Confederate flags and support streets and cities and military bases named after those who were slave owners and those who fought against the freedom of black people. I said it's not enough for you to say it. You're going to have to show, you're going to have to demonstrate that you're really done change. You can no longer host a meeting to discuss policing practices and not invite the top three black law enforcement agents. Tell somebody it's not enough. You cannot support, ban, and chokehold one moment and then in the same sentence support it. You have to make up your mind what you're going to do. In verse number 8, our text says, God tells the people, he said, I have set the land before you. Go in and possess it. Tell somebody it's time to possess the land. God said it's yours. That promise God made you is yours. Don't be fearful of the obstacles because anything that's worth having is worth fighting for. It's worth laboring for. It's worth standing for. And so he said, it's already yours. I already set the land before you. All you have to do is go in and possess it. See, the Amorites and the Canaanites, I'm putting them on notice right now. I'm coming to possess the land that God declared is mine. Tell somebody, I'm coming. Somebody ought to tweak. I'm coming to possess what God said is mine. I won't be denied any longer. My mind is made up. I'm determined. I shall persevere. I shall not be rejected or denied. To those who pretend that racism doesn't exist in America, I come by to put you on notice that change is coming whether you're ready for it or not. To those of you that's holding those high positions, whether in federal or state or local government, come on somebody, or either corporate America, I also come to put you on notice that black lives matter and we're going to vote you out of those offices. Somebody ought to say yes. To all the protesters all across the country, if you want to possess the land, if you want to see change in our systems, then you must show up in November at the voting booth, or if they mail in the ballots, whatever process that's in place, you have to make sure that your vote counts. Come on, somebody. I understand that sometimes the alternative candidate may not have everything we want, but if you choose not to do anything, you just said, I support what's happening now, and I come by to tell you, change is coming. Everything won't change and won't won't change through one election. Help me, somebody. But when folks see that we're going to hold them accountable, that you have to make my priorities your priorities, how many know change will come? Huh? If I'm talking to you, go ahead and shout and tweet. It's been long enough. It's time to possess the land. The promise of God is yea and amen. Things are about to change for us, America. We're no longer going to be what we used to be. Somebody ought to say, get ready, get ready. Here comes reform. It's time to relinquish and allow all of us to be treated fairly as one. For we all was created in the image of God. Go ahead and give God a praise offering if I've been talking to you. Come on, give God a praise offering if you're trusting in his word. If you're ready to move from this mountain, from this place, this wilderness that you've been in, and ready to go in and possess those things that God has promised to you and your forefathers. Somebody ought to just bless the name of the Lord. Someone ought to shout hallelujah. Someone ought to tweet, thank you, Jesus, because God is up to something and change is coming our way. Go ahead and bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. God bless you. I want to take a moment just in case that there's someone out there that have not invited Jesus into your heart, amen, have not accepted him as your Lord and Savior. I want to give you the opportunity, as the Bible says in Romans 10:9, that if we would confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God has raised him from the grave, you shall be saved. At this moment, you can repeat after me, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I believe that you died for my sins. I believe that God raised you from the grave with all power in your hand. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving me. If you took the time to do that, then I want you to know that you are now saved. And you can go ahead and give God a praise offering because he is now your Lord and your Savior. In fact, go ahead and reach out to us at alexandremoria.org and send us a note and say, Pastor Plater, today I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And I'll make sure that I'll reach back out to you and connect with you and continue to encourage you. My brothers and sisters, continue to hang on in there. God is with us. Let us be mindful and stay safe. And remember, whatever you do, let your voice be heard, especially come November. Make sure you get out there and vote. God bless you. Have a wonderful and great day.